with the death of Uthman, the Rafida, the Tashayyu' began. And the one who implanted this seed is Abdullah bin Saba' al-Yahudi, the Jew Abdullah bin Saba'. Who is Abdullah bin Saba'? Abdullah bin Saba' is the head of this sect known as As-Saba'iyya. And the sect used to attribute divinity to Ali. In addition, holding to the creed that he will return. And also, it makes takfir of the Sahaba. Abdullah bin Saba' originally is from Yemen, and he was a Jew who claimed Islam on the apparent, then migrated to spread his fitna to the west of Arabia, Al-Hijaz, then to Al-Basra in Iraq, then to Al-Kufa in Iraq. And he entered Damascus during the time of Uthman radiallahu anhu. The people of Damascus expelled him. So he left to Egypt. And in Egypt, he proclaimed his innovation. The news of Ibn Saba', Abdullah bin Saba', and his creed and his conspiracies are abundant in the books of sects and in the books of men and in the books of history, from the Sunnah as well as from the Shia references. If I would mention to you, I would mention to you a long list. Just to illustrate that Al-Ash'ari mentioned it, Al-Multi mentioned it, Al-Baghdadi, Al-Shahristani, Al-Isfariini, Al-Razi, Ibn al-Murtada, Ibn Hajar, Ibn Asakir, Al-Sam'ani, Ibn al-Athir, Al-Maqdisi, Tariqh al-Tabari, Ibn Kathir, Al-Bidaya wal-Nihaya, Ibn Khaldun, and from the Shia resources, Al-Nashi' al-Akbar, Masail al-Imama, page 22-23, Al-Qummi in his Maqalat, page 20. Al-Nubakhti in his Firaq al-Shia, page 22. And Al-Kashi mentioned many narrations regarding Ibn Saba' in his book, Rijal al-Kashi, in more than one place. Ibn Abi al-Hadid, Sharh Nahj al-Balagha, and others. Abdullah bin Saba' began his movement during the latter part of the reign of Uthman. Many researchers of the past and the contemporary ones hold that Ibn Saba' is the originator and establisher of the Shi'i sect and the first block in its foundation. Consider Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, who mentioned that Ibn Saba', Abdullah bin Saba', was the first to pronounce the infallibility creed regarding Ali, and that he, Ali, is textually mentioned to be the Khalifa, which is known as An-Nas, and that he, Abdullah bin Saba', intended to corrupt the deen of Islam as Paul corrupted the deen of Nasara. This is mentioned in many places by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Just to cite one, Majmu' al-Fatawa, volume 4, page 518. Similarly, Ibn al-Murtada in his book, Al-Maniyya wal-Amal, page 125. And from the contemporary ones, Abu Zahra, who mentioned that Abdullah bin Saba was the greatest taghut, and that he held the head of this sect who hated Islam and plotted to spoil it and spoil its people, and that he claimed the return of Ali, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam willed for Ali to be the Khalifa and called for that. And Abu Zahra mentioned that the fitna of Ibn Saba and his group was from the greatest fitan under its shade Shi'ism sprouted. Some of the Shia in our times, the rejectionists in our times, try to deny the existence of Abdullah bin Saba without any decisive proof. From them is Murtada al-Askari in his book Abdullah bin Saba, page 35. Not only that, some of the contemporary Shias claim that Abdullah bin Saba is Ammar bin Yasir, claim that Abdullah bin Saba is Ammar bin Yasir. And this is Ali al-Wardi in his book Wa'ad al-Salatin, page 274. And he was imitated by another Shi'i known as Mustafa al-Shaybi in his book As-Silatu Bayn al-Tasawwuf wa al-Tashayyu', page 4041, and others. This claim is an attempt or a trick to declare the Shia to be innocent from the plot of the Jews. Not only that, it is even an attempt to give a legitimate claim for the rejection and to refute their opponents by refuting that the origin of Tashayyu' goes to a Jew. However, the references of the past from Ahlus Sunnah and from the Shia as well are in agreement that Abdullah bin Saba was a reality and a historical character. So how could the contemporaries disagree on the agreement of the past researchers and historians? As to their saying is Abdullah bin Saba is Ammar bin Yasir, this is refuted intellectually and textually and historically. How could these false creeds be attached to Ammar bin Yasir? This is an insult to the companions, no doubt. We don't need to go further into the assertion that Abdullah bin Saba was a real figure, an historian figure, and that he had the greatest fitna under which the Shia rejectionist sect took of his creed or of its creed. However, for those who are more interested, then they should know that there are many excellent discussions on this matter that are present in our times. From that is the thoroughly researched work under the title Abdullah bin Saba and his role in the fitna. And the work also of Dr. Ammar al-Talibi and Dr. Izzat Atiyah.